You know what I love? I love going to bed at 7 a.m. in the morning or 8 a.m. in the morning because I'm up all night trying to finalize my NHL 21 roster because I want to make everything perfect for videos. But because you end up sleeping late, you end up waking up late. It's 11:22 as I'm recording this right now. I'm off of 3 hours of sleep and mostly, I'm kind of upset because I missed the JAYCE HAWRYLUK signing. The Vancouver Canucks signed JAYCE HAWRYLUK earlier today to a one-year deal with a pretty nice average annual value. Take a look at it. It's $800,000. But they also ended up re-signing Adam Gaudette as well. So this, honestly, it's a pretty good contract. Like, for real. I've been saying this over the past few years, but for Jim Benning and his contract signings and extensions, it's normally the youthful guys that the fans really like that we watched get drafted and eventually brought into the organization that he does very well with the contracts. It's Bo Horvat's extension. It's Brock Besser's bridge deal. It's all these contracts of guys that people are rooting to get better over the years that actually are pretty good. And that's what this is right here. $950,000 for Adam Gaudette. He's coming back. A very good, valuable third line center piece. Because it's only 1 year, we'll see how he is able to progress. And I would assume he's going to progress upwards into 2020-2021. Give him a little bit more of a solidified role in the top nine, because remember, at this time a year ago, we were debating on whether or not Gaudette was going to be able to make the team, and I said that I wanted him on the team, but if he had to spend some time in Utica, that would not be the worst thing in the world. He was still in that transition stage, you know? But for JAYCE HAWRYLUK, he's a guy who will come onto the Vancouver Canucks squad, actually do his thing. He's like a Tyler Mott, so it's a very interesting dynamic that we'll have there in our bottom six. Beagle, Mott, Howerluck's going to be there too. It's some nice depth pieces, and I'll tell you right away right now, there indeed was a video that I recorded last night. It was at about 2 a.m. in the morning. And that video was supposed to go over the idea of moving money for the purposes of getting some other players back. Free agent wingers, defensemen, re-signing that Gaudette and that Jake Virtanen. I'll upload that video in about an hour, but I'll give you a full disclosure. I talk in that video as if Gaudette was not signed. So that's kind of why some of the things we're seeing in that next video upcoming are the way they are. Because, you know, I don't want to record a video last night at 2 a.m., take years off of my life, and have to not upload it because one piece of information in the video is incorrect. But to get back on topic with Gaudette and HAWRYLUK, I actually just checked it out. He's streaming at the moment, and the love in his stream chat is just absolutely going off right now. If you're still around and this is still going on, I highly recommend checking out Hockey God on Twitch. It's kind of weird to plug the NHL player on social media and look at his platform, but he's having a ball. He's going to come back to Vancouver. He also just announced on his stream that he's going to be wearing number 96 next year because Nate Schmidt's getting 88. Jordy Benn, of all people, is getting 8, and Gaudette's going to 96. I don't really know the explanation there, but hey, it's a number. But talk to me in the comments really about HAWRYLUK and Gaudette. Hope you enjoyed this. Witcher Dash Rolls 99. And bye.